Welcome back. Today I'll be creating a layout called I Love My Tribe using the May Kiwi Club Kit. And I'll be also using the sketch that's up on the top right corner, which is an exclusive Hip Kit Club design team sketch made by Jessica Winter. And you can find it at hipkitclub.net. So the first thing I'm doing is I have already cut out my Clara Lane 3A and my a la carte Ripple B to create the edges up on the top of my page. I've already cut them out, so I just inked them real quick, and now I'm adhering them to my paper. So if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell indicator to be notified once new content is posted. So as you can see, I've taped down my paper and then decided that I forgot to add another color up top. So I am going to use this scrap piece of paper in the blue, and the backside is green. And I'll be just adhering it to the top of my page, and then I'll be adhering the Clara Lane 3A. So once this is adhered, I'm going to do a strip of the light green just so that I could have a little bit of, so I could have the three different layers, or three different colors rather, before I add my a la carte Ripple B, which I'll be cutting out of this paper here. So I just want to say thanks. Thanks for stopping by my channel. Thanks for watching. Don't forget that at 500 subscribers, I am giving away a $50 gift card to my Kiwi Lane store. This is not sponsored by Kiwi Lane, it's sponsored by me. So it basically is just a thank you for subscribing, and then I'll start thinking about what my 1,000 subscriber giveaway will be. So as you can see, I'm just cutting down my a la carte Ripple B using my Tim Holtz shears. And I believe these are the 7-inch or 6-inch shears. They're nice and big. So when you're cutting anything that has a larger shape to it, they're a great tool. So I do ink all my edges with the Tim Holtz Distress ink in the Hickory Smoke. And I am using a Scotch Advanced Tape Glider, or as they call it, ATG tape. And I usually flip back and forth between that and the Tombow. But I'm running out of Tombow and I have a lot of ATG tape, so I'm trying to use that up. So as I ink these edges, I just want to mention that the Kiwi kit is an excellent way to grow your stash. Run out of ATG tape, so now I have to change that. So I'm just going to cut that part out, and I will be cutting out a photo mat using the a la carte snapshot. This is probably one of my favorite templates. I've used it so many times. It works great to give you that vintage Polaroid look, and it easily frames out your pictures. So as I cut this out, I just want to, that's my picture there on the right and on my phone. I'm just trying to figure out what picture I wanted to use. I wanted to use the I Love My Tribe card. That was going to be like my title for my page. And that's a picture of my family when, let's see, it's actually my 43rd birthday. My youngest son was deployed and had just got home, so he was able to come home for my birthday. So I cut this out of the blue paper, and I'm going to ink my edges, I believe. Maybe not. I'm also trying to figure out what I'm going to use for my layers, and I decided to go with these cards. I thought they were the perfect colors, and they were the right sizes as well to give me sort of the look that I was looking for. Yeah, see, I decide to ink my edges after the fact. That never works, so I just did one side. So to make things easier, I like to adhere my layers together before I layer them to my actual paper, because this way, if there's other things I want to do, I can move it around and it's in one big solid piece. I am using some fun foam and to pop my picture up, and now I'm just going to adhere my layers together so that I can just move everything around as one large piece. So now that I've decided what my photo will be layered on, I'm going to work on adding some embellishment, which I end up cutting out flowers using using the a la carte forget-me-not that came in the April kit, I mean the May kit, and I also use, let's see, what's it called? The tropical, or actually, I think it's tropical. Let me check. Yeah, tropical number four, as well as tags number four, which that's what you're seeing me cut out right now. And I didn't need the entire size, so I just slid up the template to be able to cut out the exact size that I wanted. So now I'm just going to finish cutting out this card. I will be using a regular hole puncher, which I've had for probably, I don't know, maybe since I was in high school, so a long time. And I'm going to pop a hole up on the top of my tag so that I can add some twine or some baker's twine, which came in one of the kits. I believe it was the April kit. So I'm just going to add a little piece of twine here. Nothing spectacular. I'm just going to fold it in half, and I actually think I have two pieces of it. Fold it in half, slide it through, and then slide the loose ends through the hoop. So this is going to serve as my title, but I still feel like there's needs something else, so I know I'll be looking for another card shortly, but I'm looking at my flowers and trying to see where they're going to go. So I know that I want to use these flowers, and I'm just going to try to figure out what paper I want to use, which I end up using one of the pink papers for the larger flower. And I think I'm just trying to clean up a bit and figure out where everything is. I wanted to try to use that greenish color, but I don't think it was going to work out. So I'm just going through my papers, and this is the paper that I'll be using for the pink flowers, for the tropical. Let's see what I'll do with it. Tropical 4, I think it was. And yeah, so I'm cutting them out. I'm going to cut out one, and I end up cutting it in half. Since you're not really seeing the whole flower, I figured it would be, you know, a lot more effective if I just cut the flower in half and use the parts that I wanted to use. So I think for my next technique, I'm thinking about using stamps on a layout. I really do like the way it looks. I'm not sure how I'm going to work it into my layout. I have shown techniques, an embossing technique, heat embossing, but I think for this one, I'm going to stamp directly onto my page, or perhaps even stamp my embellishments and then cut them out. So my flowers are going to live in both the top and the bottom corners of my layout, and I'm just trying to see which direction looks better. And I'm feeling that right there would be great. So I'm gonna add some adhesive. And again, I'm just adding my layers to each other so that I could just move them around. So as I add my adhesive and walk away, and I'm not sure where I went, I think I'm looking for adhesive. Yep, that's exactly what it was. I had run out of the Tombow. And the reason why I like the Tombow when I'm recording is because I feel like it's less clunky in front of the camera. It's the ATG tape I absolutely love, but they're just huge. So here I'm just adding some shading, and it looks like a mess right now, and you're probably wondering, what is she doing? Straight to my paper using distress ink, in the gray hickory smoke. And basically what I'm just trying to create is like if the light was coming from above, and the layers were creating some sort of shade. I guess that's the right word. And I just want enough to peek out from my edges. And so that it doesn't look so harsh, I always start in the middle and work my way out, because that helps make it look a little bit more muted, as well as, you know, if you have too much ink on your inker and you push down on it, you're going to get a round shape, and it's going to be really hard to blend that out. So at least behind the pictures, it would be hidden. If I goof, you know, it's okay. No one would notice. So now I noticed this paper, and I said, this will work perfectly as a strip right under my picture. So I'm cutting out one strip of this flower, and it almost works like a ribbon. And I'm just gonna cut those edges off and adhere it right to my picture, or my layers here. I do end up inking it. I almost didn't, but I remembered. And now I realize that I cut the strip a little too short, so eventually I will find something to put right on top of that left corner. So I see this card and I feel like it works perfectly right there. I wanted that date to pop out, you know, and to be noticeable. So I think that's going to join in the layers. I'm happy with the way it looks. And so I'm going to cut out two of these smaller flowers, and these came in the kit and it's called a la carte forget-me-not. And for this flower, I do use my smaller Tim Holtz, I'm not sure if they're called nibs. They're like really small. They're probably like, I don't know, two and a half inches, the actual cutting portion of the scissor or the blades. So, since we're getting very close to the end of this video, I just wanted to say thank you for watching, and I really appreciate it. If you could find links in my description for all my social media, ways of finding me. Oh my God, I'm having a moment. You can also direct message me through YouTube if I'm not even sure how you do that, but I know that there is an option. But anyway, if you have any questions or you're interested in Kiwi Lane, you know, feel free to contact me. I'd be more than happy to direct you to whatever it is that you're looking for. And I appreciate all my clients that have joined in with me. Thank you so much for your orders. I'm super grateful. And for those that don't know, your orders help me continue creating content. And right now I'm working on two videos a week. I'm hoping to eventually try to get to three videos. Probably that won't happen until later in the summer. There's a lot of stuff going on in my family's life right now, and we're just trying to, you know, I'm trying to get back used to get into the new swing of things. And I just want to mention these adhesive foam circles, or I don't know what, hexagons, were gifted to me by my friend T. She was using them and she kept complaining on how hard they were to take the tape off. So she sent me a bunch just so I could see for myself. I had never seen black foam circles, and they actually use the red line adhesive, and I have to tell you, they were so hard to get that little tab off of them. So I'm gonna use my from the stickers that came, the puffy stickers that came in the kit, I'm using the little teepee, and because it's going to be raised off my page, I didn't want to leave the adhesive because I didn't want other stuff to stick behind it, you know, because I'm, all my layers, my layouts right now kind of sit in a pile until I have a chance to put them away. So I put it on vellum, and then that way the adhesive is covered. And I will be adding some art glitter glue, which is my other favorite. That's my favorite liquid adhesive. But yeah, these little circle things were a real pain. As you can see, I cannot get it up. So I have to use one of those pokey tools to be able to actually pull them off, because they are a beast. A beast, I tell you. So we're coming close to the end. I just want to say thanks again. I will be using some Heidi Swap Color Shine in the, what color is this? Teal. And it's funny because in the bottle it looks really blue, but on my layout it almost has a green tone, and it just worked perfectly. I loved it. So for those of you watching, Thanks again. Thanks for staying this long. At the end of my video, there will be links to other videos as well as still shots of and close-ups of this layout. And if you haven't, check out Hip Kit Club. I love their kits. I have no affiliation with them at all. I am just a person that shops on their site and fell in love with their kits last year. And I can't have enough of them. So if you're looking for a new kit club, they have exclusive content and they use a lot of like Paige Evans and Vicky Booten stuff. They have gorgeous, they do an amazing job of matching things up and being able to go across different companies. So I'll have the link in my descriptions. And the Kiwi Club is also one of my favorites. Those are the two kits that I personally use and I purchase every month. And I've been doing the Kiwi Club since it first started back last year. So yep, so I'm adding my flower. I'm also gonna add some sequins for my stash. I will actually run through a couple of my my tackle boxes that I have full of small embellishments to add to my little flowers, but I honestly don't see anything that I like. This little sticker says Insta This. My kids are all very much into Instagram, and slowly but surely I am also joining that Insta family. So I'm just looking around, and I love having this clear backing so that I can move things around and see where I like them. So basically this is what my layout looks like without the finishing touches, which I will start working on next. So if there's anything that you'd like to see, is there anything specific that you are having a hard time figuring out, whether it be how to use certain templates or you have any questions at all, leave me a comment and I will work it into my schedule of future videos. So this is my tackle. I have all my small embellishments basically in like color order. Like I have pinks, oranges, and reds together, and then I have like my wood veneers in one of those tackle boxes. I think it works great for very small embellishments. I like to keep my stuff by color because that's how my brain operates. And if it wasn't because my friend Leda gave me this really cool tray for my sequins, I probably would have incorporated those into my color organization as well. But yeah, I treasure this little tray here. So I'm just looking at different color sequins, and I end up going with white, like holographic, I guess that's what it's called, sequins. And I'm just going to glue three little sequences to each one of those green flowers, and right above the word date on that tag on the left. And I really love how this page came out. I love that you can use all kinds of different sketches from, you can find them on Pinterest, you can go to pagemaps.com, so many places that you can find sketches, and you can always incorporate your Kiwi Lane templates into them. So right about here, is when I realized that art glitter glue can be really sticky. And having, I finally had my nails done for Mother's Day. My daughter was like, come on, Mom, I want to take you for a manicure. And I'm not used to having long nails because I really never do. But now I'm addicted. So I went for my second manicure yesterday and love them. So now I guess I'll be getting manicures every 2 weeks. So anyway, here I'll be pulling out my Heidi Swap Color Shine. And at first I picked up the green, but I felt the green was a little too fluorescent. And I'm just going to do some controlled, as my friend T would say, controlled splatters. So thanks again for watching, and you guys have a great weekend.